If innovation was to be attributed to some of the world's structures, then the i360 would certainly be that. What will soon be the tallest observation tower outside of London, it will also be the thinnest at a height-to-diameter ratio of 40 to 1. As the Jekin Tower works its way through pushing 17 steel cans to the dizzy heights of 162 metres, things are on the up.
We've started the first jacking operation. So just to talk you through what's going on, we've got can 3 that has now been taken out and taken onto the skid track, and that's now going to be placed onto the beach area. And then we're going to be lifting can 13 onto the skid track and placing it within the tower. So when it comes to tonight, the tower will be 6 metres taller than what it was this morning, because we've taken out can 3 at 6 metres and we're putting in can 13 at 12 metres. So a big day for the project, and here's to a successful build.
The process to build the tower has been years in the making, with every part of this grand project planned out to the finest detail. The Jekin Tower is a key instrument into making this a success, eliminating the need for cranes to lift the structure.
This is a very difficult engineering project. It's an exceptionally tall, thin tower that really is on the sort of leading edge of design of very tall, thin structures. There are buildings taller than this tower, but there's nothing of this height that is this thin, and it is that feature which really drives the design. The tower is about 4 metres in diameter, and the jacking tower has the ability to lift these top four sections up into the air, off the foundation, and create enough clearance to put the next can, number 13, in at the bottom. So it's all done at ground level, but it gets heavier each time because you lift 5 cans next time, and then 6 cans, and then 7. And the very last jacking operation, when we put the last one in at the bottom, we're lifting almost 1,000 tons up through the tower.
So a logistical task on a huge scale, and as the height of the cans increases, so too does excitement, as onlookers watch on at Brighton's seafront and skyline changing forever. This is James Dunham for Latest TV News.